Hello class 8, hope you all are good. Now let's continue chapter 1, transportation system in plants. In previous video we discussed about structure of root hairs, xylem, phloem tissues and process occurs in plants which help in absorption of water and minerals by the roots and how this water reaches to the tip of the plants. Let's continue the next step, that is your transpiration. Children, all of you know plants, they absorb large quantity of water as well as mineral source from the soil with the help of their roots. This water is conducted or transported in upward direction up to the tip of stem, branches and leaves. Now by the process called ascent of sap. Okay, from the absorbed water, only 1 to 2% of water is utilized by the plants for the process which is required for the process of photosynthesis and other processes, right? But the remaining 98 to 99% of water, it is lost by the process that is called, but through these exposed parts of the plant, by the process called transpiration, right? So what is transpiration? Transpiration is a what is a loss of water in the form of water vapors is known as transpiration. Now transpiration takes place in different regions. There are three main types of transpirations are there. First is your stomatal transpiration, right? Cuticular transpiration and lenticular transpiration. Now first is your stomatal transpiration. Evaporation of water from the leaves taking place through the stomata is called stomatal transpiration, right? Stomatal transpiration, I think, what are stomatas? These are the tiny pores which are present on the surface of leaves. Now next is your cuticular transpiration. When the evaporation of water takes place directly from the surface of leaves and herbaceous stem, it is known as cuticular transpiration. Actually, cuticular transpiration is a loss of water takes place from the directly from the surface of the leaves. Next is your lenticular and bark transpiration. When evaporation of water takes place through the lentices and the bark, it is called lenticular transpiration. Now what is what are lenticels? Lenticels are the tiny pores which are present on the bark of old woody trees. I think all of you have seen the bark of old woody trees in mango trees and in this. Okay, one more term is there or process there which also help in ascent of sap. That is called transpiration pull. What is transpiration pull? The loss of water from the leaves through the transpiration creates a suction pressure. That is, creates a force in the xylem vessels and pulls up water from the roots through the stem to the leaves. And this is called what? Transpiration pull. This transpiration pull also help in ascent of sap. What is ascent of sap? Upward movement of water and minerals. Right? Now next is your wilting. What is wilting? When the rate of transpiration is greater, when loss of water from the exposed part of the plant is more than the rate of absorption of water, it means the roots, they are absorbing water, absorbing less water, and loss of water is more. Then then the leaves, stem and flowers of the plant, they begin to droop, and this is called wilting, right? Okay, now next is your factors influencing transpiration. There are some factors which affect the rate of transpiration, and these are, first is your temperature. What is how the temperature affect the transpiration? The rate of transpiration increases with increase in temperature. If temperature is more, then rate of transpiration will be also high. Now next is your light. During daytime, stomata remains open, hence most of the transpiration takes place during daytime. So if more naturally if more light is there, that more transmission will takes place. But at night, what's happened? The stomata remain closed, so very little amount of water is lost by cuticular or lenticular transmission, because lenticels are remain open during daytime and night time, but stomatas, they remain open during daytime only. They are closed at night time. Next is your humidity. The amount of water content of air is known as humidity. What is humidity? I think all of you know. It is a amount of water vapors present in the air. And if humidity is more, if with increase in humidity, the rate of transmission decreases. If more water vapors are present in the air, then loss of water from the leaves of the surface of the leaves would takes place less. Right. Next is your wind speed. The rate of transmission increase in moving air, because moving air carries away water vapors from the leaves as fast as it comes out of stomata. So these are the main four factors which affect rate of transpiration. Now next is your importance of transpiration. The first is your how the transpiration is helpful to the plants. It generate a suction force in xylem, which can pull water from the roots up to the great height in the tall trees. I just told you about the transpiration pool. Transpiration pool also help in ascent of sap, right? Next is your it cools the plant in hot weather. Okay, next discuss importance of minerals. All of you know, roots, they absorb water and minerals from the soil. Now, minerals are very important for the healthy growth of plants. And there are two main categories of minerals are there. One is your macronutrients and the second one is your micronutrients. Macronutrients are the mineral elements that are required in large quantities by the plants. And they include nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium and sulfur. While the second type of minerals are micronutrients, which are required in extremely small quantities by the plants, and they include iron, manganese and zinc and many more. Thank you, children.